Hello and welcome to The Sightings. And today in The Sightings, we have something brand new. This stuff right here. These are the London Southwestern Railway six-wheeled coach block sets. So this is LSWR wartime livery with a blank nameplate. More traditional LSWR. Over here, here we go. And then you get the Southern Olive one. And they are customizable for nameplates and destination boards. So I can, if I really wanted to, I could even show you. It means I'd have to wait through AI traffic again. I'm gonna go with I think no RN is a running number. Shoot. Where's the manual? I've always hated that mentality that oh, as a real man, you don't need the manual. Bullshit. By adding D equals, okay. Equals. So yeah. I hit 98, not 198. Okay, so just a quick heads up. 98 through 112 are reserved for Golden Age development, so as they find new destinations and things, or as we get new destinations from, say, the west of England mainline where these coaches would have run and stuff, they're going to be giving us more destination boards. I want to see if it's in here. Yes, there we go. There we go, Lyme Regis. Yeah, because we're going to be getting phase two, I think, soonish. They don't really say that much, so yeah. And now we can continue on with our examination, because there are a ton. So as you can see, I've put down every single sodding set. So you get the more traditional four coach, five coach, five and four coach, nine coach, 10 coach, 13 coach, and 14 coach sets in various liveries. I'll get to all the views and stuff in a minute, but let's get to the engines. Because the selection is intriguing to say the very least. So we're gonna start here. We're gonna go T3, T9, 700, Adams Radial, LSWR A12, and M7. Now, I think as we get more and more LSWR engines, and I'm gonna go do myself a favor. While I talk about this, I feel like we're gonna be getting these coaches used more and more. So, here are my ideas of these engines that are going to be used. Where are you, anyway? So, looking at the LSWR Adams O2, this is off the Caledonia Works website. The Class 395. I'm also gonna hazard a guess on the CNT 14s and maybe the LSWR D15s. Possible with the G6, H16, and G16 classes as well, but I don't know. We'll just have to wait and see. And then I think the 0298 are the Beattie Well tank. Yep, they're the BT Wells. So, they're a possible? I'm not gonna say yes, I'm not gonna say no. I'm just gonna say they're a possible. But you won't see these coaches in BR. And why not? These coaches were withdrawn by the end of the 1930s, believe it or not. However, there is a potential for a BR set, mainly to do around Lyme Regis. But you can get away with saying, oh, I managed to snag a 14 coach in LSWR and a 5 and 4 coach set in SR liveries for my Heritage Railway. Which is where I feel like these would fit in as a good starter heritage fleet. Let's say your railway's, I don't know, 9 miles long. These would be perfect for, starting out. Take a five coach set, couple it with maybe a birdcage or two, and boom. You're off and running at the races. Now, do I have a problem with this set? I'm going to reserve the word problem. I'm going to say that I can see people not really liking it due to the fact that the coaches are blocked. They're not individual six-wheelers. And you're gonna be, well, I can look up LSWR six wheelers and there's individual ones. So why aren't we getting the individual ones? I would say wait. I'm not gonna say, oh, it's perfect. I'm not gonna say this is a good idea. No, here's what I'm gonna say. Wait and see. As for these coaches, the fact that they're blocked could make things a little more complicated operations-wise if you're running on a very tight space or your heritage railway doesn't have that much playroom. So, here's my thought process. If you want them, go for them. And they're not that much. 10 pound, 13 pound, I think. And I will be honest, they're fun. I haven't played with them. This is actually my very first look at them, but they are already look exciting. And we're gonna come back here to our friend, the A12. So this is, we get a guard's view. I believe this is first class. I love the guard's view. So, I'm gonna get our engine ready to go, and I'm gonna shut up and let the coaches. Speak for themselves. So, first. They do have opening doors. Which is a nice. I love it when things are like this are added. It just really feels so alive. Now, you might be going, oh, well, with like the AP Mark ones and with some of the Matrix Trains coaches, you get a guard's whistle, but we don't get that here. I'm gonna hold off judgment. Because I don't really think that's necessary. It's you do you. I'm gonna stop right now. I'm gonna wait for a train to pass, and then we're out of here. Okay, as we coast into the station, what are my thoughts on these coaches? Well, they fill a gap kind of in the roster. I like unique things, and this is unique. Number two, I really feel like, oh, you want to get away with some stuff on a little branch line? Where, you know, like, two big coaches is going to be too much? Perfect for that. Three, you want to start off on a heritage railway? Boom, done. You don't need monster coaches. Just a little nine set of this and you're off to the races. You have these smaller engines. They're easier to work with. You can even use some of the bigger engines. You could even imagine this behind like a Black 5 or something. And what do you know? It could happen. You're running around going, yes, good, wee. Let's party. Local trains up and down branch lines like Granfield, where we are right now. Bada bing, bada boom, done. Do these have handbrakes? They do have handbrakes. So, that is these coach packs done. I'll see you in the next review. Bye.